Dude, I'm gonna have to call Joey Swoles and tell him that you keep getting in my shots. You're blocking the camera. Now you're on my workstation here. I'm using this, bro. I got my towel right here. My timer's right there. I'm only taking 10-minute breaks. I'm just kidding. I mean, you guys are funny. Funny boys. Good morning. Welcome back. Good to see you again. It's another morning. Another cool-ish morning. Very humid out though. But in the gym, it is surprisingly comfortable right now. Comfortable, but I have no doubt we're going to be sweating our butt off by the end of this workout. That is absolutely certain. First and foremost though, it's a big day. It's Balu's birthday. You can't see him right now. He is sleeping away in that little bed of his over there. But the big guy himself is 5 years old today. I love that dog so much. I know you guys see him from time to time, but undoubtedly my best friend in the whole wide world. And he deserves the best of days. So I think later today, we're going to get him some doggy treats, maybe a doggy cupcake or two at the pet store, and make sure he gets his favorite toy in the whole world, which are squeaky tennis balls. Absolutely loves the damn things. So we're going to go treat him to that later this evening, spend some time together, and have a good old time. But we've got today's workout ahead of us. And as you can see, it's going to be something pretty unique. That's for sure. We don't say that very often, but we're throwing in quite a few new exercises that are really going to jazz up this workout for the foreseeable future here. And we're starting off strong with some deficit lever arm rows. Now that may sound a little bit complicated, but it's really not. We're just going to stand on something to give us a bit of an elevation, get us off the ground a bit so that we can get that row even deeper than we normally would as opposed to just standing flat foot on the ground there. This will allow it to get a little bit deeper there. We're not going anything too crazy. We'll stack about two plates worth or a bumper plate on the ground, get ourselves elevated a little bit there, and take those rows nice and deep. The other interesting one you're seeing here is that Moto Cable row. And I hope you stick around to see exactly what that is. I saw a video on this, I saw some guy doing it, and I was like, I can do that, number one. And two, that's pretty unique, that's different. What the heck is a Moto Cable row? Well, we're gonna find out today. I hope you stay tuned for that. We've got all of these great exercises ahead of us, so let's get after that workout. But do me a favor, go down to the comments right now, wish Baloo a happy birthday. I'll read them all to him, I promise. He loves getting all the comments. Let's get after today's workout. Let's get set up, let's get warmed up, and let's get cranking.
Did you wish your brother a happy birthday? You did? Are you sure? Okay. That's very nice of you.
Lever arm rows are always an interesting movement. Because of the way the arm moves, it pivots, right? It's not just a straight up and down movement like you would find on a Smith machine or like you could do with a barbell. It almost doesn't feel natural, the path that those handles take, because they are, in effect, as they move up, moving closer to the camera from this angle and getting closer to you all through that movement, which is just not a very natural thing. Now, you could change that by turning around and kind of rowing them into you. That's one way to solve for that. But we're right on the edge of that. It's really not until we're almost all the way towards the top of that movement that we start to feel that weirdness and that angle pulling us that way. So I think we're gonna do one more in this setup. We're not changing anything from that first set, but one way I think we can combat this is by bringing those arms up a little bit. Maybe two settings here on the rack, maybe about 4 inches. Getting them a little bit higher, a little bit higher. This is working out well for us. Let's do another set here. All right, we're just gonna try this. I just gotta give it a go. We're gonna use our handles here just to see how this changes this overall movement. I'm wondering if it'll give us a little bit more ability to actually pull this into our stomach. That's what we're trying to do, right? Pull the handles up into our stomach. Let's try it. Let's just try it with the handles, see what happens.
Ugh.
Okay. That was perfect. It eliminated completely the concerns we had about those lever arms kind of pulling forward at the top range of that movement, because when it gets there, that lever arm can pull toward you all, but the handle will pivot and it'll come towards us. It was perfect. This was literally perfect. So I think we're gonna keep doing these with the handles. Wow, amazing, I love it. Those felt really good. We're gonna add long length partials to this, so every other rep will be a bit of an integrated partial. You'll see what I mean here. Full rep, half rep, full rep, half rep. I think that was 10. I don't know. It's kind of wonky to count. I lost count there because I was talking to you guys. So we're using the neutral grip here. So our hands are facing each other, right? Our thumbs pointed towards our face. I'm using the medium grip here. Medium grip always sounds weird, doesn't it? Like, what's in the middle of narrow grip and wide grip? I don't know. Let me know down in the comments how stupid I am for calling it medium grip. But we haven't used that medium grip in quite some time. Instead of going with that wide grip, which is more of the traditional width that we're wanting for pull-ups and pull-downs, just decided to do the medium grip today. Give it a go, change it up, keep the muscles guessing, right? Confuse those muscles, just like you are all the time. They're always confused. No, this is not the birthday boy. Birthday boy is sleeping over here. I don't know if you can see him in the camera, but he's right over here. But every time I talk to you all, Mr. Moco has to come and check out what's going on. All right, let's do this, third set, final set. All right, y'all, this is gonna be one of the weirder ones we've done here. This is basically a prone cable row. We're gonna be pulling this in one hand at a time here. Ah, it's a good stretch though. Keep that forearm in line with the cable. Other side. Oh, that's great. Dude, I'm gonna have to call Joey Swoles and tell him that you keep getting in my shots. You're blocking the camera. Now you're on my workstation here. I'm using this, bro. I got my towel right here. My timer's right there. I'm only taking 10-minute breaks. I'm just kidding. You guys are funny. Funny boys. Number two here. Up the weight just a little bit. Let's see how this feels. Oh, yeah. Oh boy. Yeah. Probably a little too much, but we'll finish this out. Definitely a little too much. Well, if you saw the last video, the easy curl bar broke in that. The collar came just unwelded completely. I am gonna attempt to JB weld it. I don't see why that wouldn't work. It's not load bearing. It's just the back of the collar that stops the weight from like going into the bar where your hands are. So I'm gonna try to JB weld that here. I just haven't had time to do it just yet. But
Thankfully, we have another easy curl bar. Slightly different variation. It's got some more extreme angles on where your hand goes. And today we're going to be doing these preacher curl style half reps. So we're only going to be coming up halfway and really letting it come all the way down with each and every single rep. Let's do it. Yeah. 15 more, come on. Half reps. Gosh, those are tough. Wow. Whew. Number three, last one here, come on. I don't know why, man. I love this exercise, though. Good chest support. You can use your bench on an incline if you don't have one of these type of supports, but these things are awesome. Absolutely love them for frying those rear delts. Do it. Yeah. All right, y'all. We got one more set of these dumbbell flies to crank out here. And then I've got a couple sets of shrugs to do as well on those lever arms. But I'm going to do those as I clean up around here a little bit, wipe down some sweat, namely on that pad. And then I'd like to sweep these floors and mop these floors too, because there's fur and dust all over the damn place. Thanks for being here. Thanks for showing up today. Every single day poses new challenges for us, and we've got to overcome obstacles that we didn't maybe foresee yesterday, we didn't anticipate, or we truly thought we had removed any chance of them showing up in our day-to-day life. But when they show up, we've just got to tackle them head on, move through it. I'm telling you, it's going to be so much easier to move through that thing you're worried about, to get that worry over with, to tackle it head on and deal with it, versus continue and sit there and think about it, talk about it, and then continue to stress and worry over it. Face it head on, get it done, and before you know it, you'll be on to the next thing. You'll be better off for it. I'll see you all next time.